हरे कृष्णा। हिस्ट्री ऑफ भीष्म देव। व्हाई हिस्ट्री? बिकॉज वी नीड आंसर्स टू सर्टेन क्वेश्चंस। व्हाई डिड भीष्म देव टुक द वॉ ऑफ लाइफ लॉन्ग सेलिबेसी? हाउ डिड ही गेट द बेनेडिक्शन ऑफ इच्छा मृत्यु? हु गेव इट टू हिम? Why did Bhishma Dev didn't speak a word when Draupadi was being disrobed in the middle of the assembly? And why did Bhishma Dev fight from the side of Duryodhan, knowing it very well that Duryodhan was on the side of irreligion? Then what are the 8 other names of Bhishma Dev? So we need answers to these questions. So starting with 8 other names of Bhishma Dev. Who was Bhishma Dev? Actually, in his previous life, he was one of the Ashtavasus. He was the 8th Vasu or elemental god. Hence, he was also known as Ashtavasu. Then because he took birth in the lineage of King Bharat, in the descendants of King Bharat, so he was also known as Bharatvamshi. Then because he was born to Mother Ganges, he was also known as Gangaputra. And because he proved to be the true son of Shantanu, King Shantanu, hence he was also known as Shantanavaha. Then when he was born, he was given the name of Devrat. And when he was born, that time his body was very fair in complexion. Hence he was also known as Gaurang. Then as a warrior, he was known as Shvetvirah, because every weapon, even his rath and the flag he possessed, the dress he wore, all was white in color. So Shvet Veera. And because he was grandfather to Kauravas as well as the Pandavas, he was known as Pitamaha. And we all know that he is also known as Bhishma because of the fierce woe he took. So these are the 8 other names of Bhishma Dev. Now how did he take birth? So his mother was river goddess Ganges and father was Shantanu. But when Shantanu approached mother goddess Ganges for marriage, she agreed on one condition, that he won't question any action of hers in future. So Shantanu, upon being agreed, then they married, and they subsequently they begot 7 children. But every time when the child was born, Mother Ganges used to drown that child immediately after taking birth of that child in the river. But Shantanu couldn't question anything because as he had promised, and Mother Ganges would go away if he had asked any question. So subsequently, when the 8th son was born, then Shantanu couldn't hold himself. And upon being frustrated, he questioned Mother Ganges, that why is she doing, is she drowning every child? Then that time, Mother Ganges revealed that these 7 sons which she drowned, they were the first 7 Vasus in their previous lives. And this child is the 8th or Ashtavasu. But since they were cursed by Vashisht sage in their previous birth, because they tried to steal the Kamdhenu cow of sage Vashisht. So upon being caught, they were cursed by sage Vashisht to take birth in this mortal world. But upon feeling repentful, the curse was diminished, that as soon as they will be born, So their tenure will be over, and they will be able to go back to their heaven. But because the plan was made by the Ashtavasu upon being enticed by his wife, so he was held more responsible, and subsequently he was cursed severely, to the extent that he had to live a very long life in this mortal world without any wife and children. So this was the story behind the birth of Bhishma. So, but because Shantanu questioned Mother Ganges, so now Mother Ganges told that I would be taking Devrat along with me. He would not stay with you anymore, but I would take him to the heaven, and I would give him proper training so that he can become a good ruler. So she took Devrat now to heaven and got him trained by eminent sages. So who were the teachers of Bhishmadev actually? So he was taught by Brihaspati, sage Brihaspati, political science. He was taught by Shukracharya, political science. He was taught by Vashishth sage, Vedas and Vedangas, as also by Chavayana Muni. Then he was taught by Sanat Kumar, the mental and spiritual sciences. Then he was taught by Markandeya Rishi. He was taught about the duties of the Yatis. And he was taught by Lord Parshuram himself, the military warfare. And by Indra, he was bestowed celestial weapons. So these were the great teachers who taught Bhishmadev. Upon being duly trained in all these subjects, Mother Ganges returned Devrat to Shantanu now. And now he joined his father in the management of the court of the state. What happened during the, as Shantanu, during as Mother Ganges went away, she had to go back because Shantanu king had broken his promise. So in the meanwhile, Shantanu fell in love with a fisherwoman by the name Satyavati, and he approached her for marriage. But the father of that fisherwoman, Satyavati, he wouldn't agree, because he wanted the children, the future children of Satyavati and Shantanu, to become the heir to the throne or the kingdom. But as Shantanu had already promised the throne to Devrat as per the rules of the state, so it was not possible, and Shantanu became very disappointed. So now Devrat, upon discovering this fact, the reason for despondency for his father, that he was not able to marry Satyavati, now Devrat took the lifelong vow of Brahmacharya. He in fact directly went to the Satyavati's father, and he took the vow of lifelong Brahmacharya, so that he would not beget any children, and subsequently there would not be any claim to the throne, thus sacrificing his crown prince. And hence he came to be called Bhishma because of this fierce vow. Now, but this was not sufficient actually. There was something more coming up. Now the subjects of the state of Hastinapur, they started criticizing the king, because they knew Devrat to be such an able with such an with such good qualities to rule over the state. But now in future they questioned about the capability and the nobility of unborn children to Satyavati and Shantanu, Satyavati being a fisherwoman. So in case of any emergency, who would be held responsible? If the future king is not able to protect the kingdom. So now again, now Bhishma took another vow of service to whosoever sat on the throne of his father, to protect the kingdom in all circumstances. So this was the second part of his vow. And thus Shantanu was able to marry Satyavati. And Shantanu, being pleased with his son because of his sacrifice, now Shantanu gave the benediction of Ichchamrityu to choose the moment of his death to Bhishma Dev. So now we know. So hence Bhishma Dev came to be called as, hence Devrat came to be called as Bhishma. Now, during the course of his tenure, when Bhishma was looking for a bride for his stepbrother Vichitravirya, he abducted the three princesses of Kashi, Amba, Ambika and Ambalika, from their Swayamvar ceremony, after defeating all the princes present over there, as is well accepted in one of the marriages for Kshatriyas in Dharma. But when he brought the three princes to Hastinapur, that time Amba revealed that she was in love with King Shalva. So Bhishma Dev sent Amba back to King Shalva, but Shalva had a humiliating defeat from Bhishma Dev, so he didn't accept Amba back and sent Amba back to Bhishma Dev. Now Amba came back to Vichitravirya, but Vichitravirya told that having given once in charity, now he couldn't accept her back. So Amba was left nowhere to go. And now Amba approached Bhishma to marry her. But Bhishma, because of his promise, couldn't accept her. So now Amba went to Parshuram, Lord Parshuram, blaming Bhishma as the cause of her suffering. And Parshuram now ordered Bhishma Dev to marry Amba. But Bhishma politely refused, stating the reason for his promise. But he told that he is ready to give up his life, but he cannot break his promise as per Dharma. So now, because Amba had approached Parshuram, now there was a fierce battle between Parshuram and Bhishma Dev for 23 continuous days. But there was no final decision, because both were very great warriors. So now, actually, at the behest of Narad and other demigods, Parshuram had to declare this war as stalemate. And Amba now left nowhere to go. Now she started doing penances in order to destroy Bhishma. And she got the benediction from her austerities. She got the benediction of taking birth as Shikhandi in her subsequent life, and to be instrumental in Bhishma Dev's death. So this was Shikhandi. So now we know from all this history that Bhishma Dev was none other than demigod himself in his previous life. He was born in a great lineage of Bharat Maharaj, Bharat Vamshi. He was born to Ganges' mother and Shantanu king. And he was trained by such eminent sages. Then